Yo, Isaac, where are you, man? We're filming. What? You've been gone all week?
All right, Isaac, this one's coming centered. It's centered, man. Where you at? Where you at, man? Dude, are you still in spawn? Okay. All done. Isaac, how's your side going? What? Aw, man.
Huh. This makes a lot more sense. Hey everyone, welcome to the latest episode of AMD Now Playing. For all the new subscribers that just joined the AMD gaming channel, we're glad to have you. This is going to be your one-stop shop to catch up on everything happening in the world of AMD gaming. Whether into hardware, software, or you just want to hang out and talk games, we've got you covered. It has been a jam-packed week of announcements coming out of Computex, and there's been so much exciting news to share. For today's special episode of AMD Now Playing, we're going to quite simply step through some of the biggest news from AMD gaming and check out the newest Ryzen CPUs. Now, before we step into all the exciting Ryzen content, a couple quick updates I want to give the rest of the community. For starters, Radeon owners, driver 24.6.1 is expected to launch towards the end of June. Make sure you download this driver from AMD.com or from AMD Software Adrenaline Edition. This is going to give you day zero driver support for the first Descendant and Once Human, as well as hypertune support to several new titles, including Overwatch 2, F124, and Like a Dragon 8, Infinite Wealth. Next, I have a quick PSA for all my Radeon gamers that are grinding CS2. I got some fantastic news for you. Anti-Lag 2, our new latency reduction technology, is available in Counter-Strike in technical preview. Anti-Lag 2 is our new game-integrated technology that decreases input-to-display response times. Essentially, it makes your games feel more responsive, and hopefully it'll make it that much easier to climb the ranks. Check out the link below for a blog the team put together that highlights Anti-Lag 2, its integration in Counter-Strike 2, as well as the type of latency reduction you can expect to see on your Radeon RX 7000 series card. Okay, and last update for the community, and then I promise we get to the Ryzen news. ASUS announced a refreshed ROG Ally at Computex called the ROG Ally X. Now, if you've been watching the show long enough, you know I am a sucker for my ROG Ally. I think it's probably one of the best handhelds I think I've ever owned. Currently, I'm playing Ghost of Tsushima on it, and with the Ryzen Z1 Extreme, you get great performance and great efficiency. And with Ghost of Tsushima, you have FSR 3, which means you get frame generation running on the Ally. At the 15-watt mode, I'm usually around 60 FPS, and when I'm plugged into the wall at the 30-watt mode, say I'm gaming on the couch and I'm just watching a movie, I'm actually well over 60. I'm closer to like 75-ish FPS in most areas. It's fantastic. So the ROG Ally X is the refreshed model of the ROG Ally, and this gives you better ergonomics, better thumbsticks. It gives you double the battery life. Those are my quick updates. Now let's get into the part of the episode that we've really been waiting for. Let's talk Ryzen. At Computex 2024, AMD, along all of our partners, had so many great announcements to share with the tech community. For the gamers and creators, the part that matters the most to you are going to be the Zen 5 powered Ryzen CPUs. On the desktop, that's our Ryzen 9000 series, and on mobile, that's going to be our Ryzen AI 300 series. Let's check them out.
Our new Ryzen 9000 CPUs are the world's fastest consumer PC processors, bringing our new Zen 5 core to the AM5 platform with support for the latest I/O and memory technologies, including PCIe 5 and DDR5. I'm happy to show you now our brand new Zen 5 core. Zen 5 is actually the next big step in high-performance CPUs. It's a grounds-up design that's extremely high-performance and also incredibly energy-efficient. You're going to see Zen 5 everywhere, from supercomputers to data centers and PCs. Compared to Zen 4, we get double the instruction bandwidth, double the data bandwidth between the cache and floating-point unit, and double the AI performance with full AVX 512 throughput. All of this comes together in the product in Ryzen 9000 series, and we're delivering an average of 16% higher IPC across a broad range of application benchmarks and games compared to Zen 4. So now, let me show you the top of the line Ryzen 9 9950X for the very first time. There you go. We have 16 Zen 5 cores, 32 threads, up to 5.67 gigahertz boost, a large 80 megabyte cache, at 170 watt TDP. This is the fastest consumer CPU in the world.
Now, if this is your first time hearing Zen or Zen architecture, don't sweat it, let me catch you up. We first introduced Zen with our first generation Ryzen CPUs a couple years ago, and we've been evolving our Zen architecture with each new major iteration of Ryzen. Zen 5 is actually a pretty big fundamental change to the CPU architecture and really brings more performance. What this means for the gamers and creators, expect a better experience overall, and you have the latest tech to keep your system feeling fresh for years to come. AMD Ryzen 9000 series is going to be your gateway to experiencing Zen 5 on the desktop. You've got about 16% more performance versus previous generation across mixed workloads, and it's able to do that while staying either flat or better on power across the stack. So at Computex, we announced a range of processors that fall into this product family. We're going to have four SKUs ranging from Ryzen 5 to Ryzen 9, starting off with 6-core 12 threads, going as high as 16-core 32 threads. Upgrading to a Ryzen 9000 series CPU is actually extremely simple. Depending on if you're a gamer or a creator, depending on your budget and what your expected feature set is out of your platform, there's a unique, customized Ryzen 9000 series experience just waiting for you. We have the Ryzen 5 9600X. This is a 6-core, 12-thread CPU. You get awesome Zen 5 gaming out of this. If you need more cores and threads, say you're a content creator, we have our Ryzen 7 and Ryzen 9 CPUs. Now at the very high end, we have our Ryzen 9 9950X. With this CPU, you get 16 cores and 32 threads of Zen 5 awesomeness. It just rips through your games and flies through your content creation workloads. It's the greatest CPU for any enthusiast, gamer, or creator out there. So these CPUs are all drop-in ready with your existing AM5 motherboards. So say you had a B650 board or an X670 board, you can actually go pick up these latest Ryzen 9000 series CPUs and just drop them right in. They're fantastic options with your existing AM5 motherboard. Now, if you've been on the fence about upgrading to AM5 and you aren't sure if it's the right time, at Computex, two big announcements. Firstly, we announced that AM5 is going to be the socket of choice until 2027, continuing that legacy of longevity with Ryzen and our platforms. Now, if you're looking for a more modern AM5 platform outside of our existing B650 boards and X670 boards, we announced a new X870 platform. So this is the X870 and X870E. These boards give you the same features as our existing 600 series, but now it makes USB 4 standard, it makes PCIe Gen 5 for storage and graphics standard, and it gives you higher DDR5 memory speeds. It's really a fantastic option for any ultra enthusiast out there. Now for the rest of the gamers that aren't gonna be going ultra enthusiast, picking up any of these 600 series boards on sale is a fantastic option to maximize your value and upgrade. The last big update from Computex was with our Ryzen AI CPUs. Let's check them out.
Our new Ryzen AI series actually is a significant increase in compute and AI performance and sets the bar for what a Copilot PC should do. Thank you, Drew. Here we go. This is Strix. Strix is our next generation processor for ultra-thin and premium notebooks, and it combines our new Zen 5 CPU, faster RDNA 3.5 graphics, and the new XDNA 2 NPU. Now, we have a couple of SKUs. The flagship Ryzen 9 HX370 has 12 Zen 5 cores, 24 threads, 36 megabytes of cache, the industry's most integrated NPU, and our latest RDNA graphics. Strix is simply the best mobile CPU.
So as I mentioned, Zen 5 is going to find its way to mobile with our Ryzen AI 300 chips. Now, as soon as the keynote ended, I don't think I've ever seen my Discord DMs explode like how they did after the CPU was announced. Now, the best way I've been explaining it to people is imagine taking an advanced CPU, GPU, and AI architecture, throw them to a silicon blender, mix it around, take the best parts of each, and out comes a laptop chip that has all the performance needed for a powerhouse system, but at the same time, it just sips on power. It's really cool. You get Zen 5 for the CPU, so you get great performance and efficiency, like we just covered. You get RDNA 3.5 graphics, which is gonna give you console-level gaming on the go, which is crazy for a laptop. And when you pair that gaming performance with an NPU that's built on the XDNA 2 architecture, you're getting up to 50 tops of AI performance that you can use for whatever workload you can imagine. Text to image, large language models, any type of AI accelerated content creation. There's so many opportunities with having an AI engine inside your system that delivers 50 TOPS of performance, but also does it while sipping on power with that XDNA 2 architecture. This is really a CPU that has everything you can need for a powerhouse system in a single chip. It's really cool. And that wraps up our Computex 2024 coverage. Thank you so much for tuning in. Trust me, I can sit here all day and talk tech with you. Me and Isaac will be back next month with our regularly scheduled programming, so expect plenty of Radeon, plenty of Ryzen, lots of games, and all the software in between. It's going to be a great time. Please remember to like and subscribe, and until then, we'll see you on the next episode of AMD Now Playing.